We're going to look at an easy example of finding the lowest common multiple of two numbers, and then we're going to have a look at an example where it's actually used. So we're going to find the lowest common multiple of 8 and 12. So first of all, we'll write down the multiples of 8, or some of them. So we start with the number itself, 8, and then it's just really writing down 2 times 8, 3 times 8, and so on. We don't really know how far we want to go, but we'll just write a few down, and then we'll write down the multiples of 12, or some of the multiples of 12. So those are the first few multiples of 8, and then looking at 12. Now this time, we're going to compare with the other list. So as soon as we've got one in common, we'll stop. There's no need to go any further. So 1 times 12 is 12, 2 12s are 24, and we've done it. We found our answer, because we want to know the lowest common multiple. So we found that 24 is in common, it's in both of our lists, so it's the lowest one as well. We haven't got another one that's the same in both lists, have we? We could go on, write down more multiples of 12, and we would see that the next common multiple is 48, but that's not really of any interest to us. So now going on to have a look at how we could use this. If we were doing an example where we're doing fraction, addition, or subtraction. So for example, we'll do 3/8 minus a 12th. So I'm using the 8 and the 12 in the denominators. Then we know the simplest way to do this is by using the 24 in the denominator. So I've multiplied the 8 by 3 to get 24. So I'll multiply 3 by 3 to get 9. And then 12, I've multiplied 12 by 2 to get 24. So I'm going to multiply 1 by 2 to get 2. So 3/8 is 9/24, 1/12 is 2/24. So that gives me 9 minus 2 divided by 24. So that's 7/24. So if we hadn't used the lowest common multiple, what we might have done is said, well, we could multiply the 8 and 12 together. What would that give us? That would be 96. So we would have ended up with 36 over 96 and 8 over 96. That would have given us 28 over 96, which would, when we cancel down, divide numerator and denominator by 4, that would give us the same answer as 7 over 24. But you can see it's much simpler to use the lowest common multiple when you're looking at working with fractions, well, adding or subtracting fractions.